Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chansom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 18th of May. India extends lockdown till May 31st. Total coronavirus cases cross 96,000 mark. Taliban suicide bomber kills 7 troops in Afghanistan's Ghazni city. And tea prices soar in Sri Lanka despite COVID-19 supply disruptions. And now for all the details. India's tally of coronavirus cases crossed the 96,000 mark on Monday with the sharpest spike of 5,242 new cases in 24 hours. This comes as the country has entered into fourth phase of a nationwide lockdown until May 31st with considerable relaxations. With the sharpest spike of 5,242 new cases in 24 hours, India's coronavirus cases tally jumped to 96,169 on Monday, with at least 3,029 deaths reported so far. Heavy traffic was seen in national capital New Delhi and nearby areas on Monday as the country entered into its fourth phase of lockdown until May 31st with considerable relaxations. The government has allowed shops and markets to reopen, excluding in containment zones. Delivery of non-essential services has also been permitted except in containment zones. Schools, malls and other public places will, however, remain closed. Salons, beauty parlors, stationery and meat shops open in parts of the country as customers reach to groom themselves and buy items from the shops.
बहुत अच्छा फील हो रहा है. दो महीने से घर में थे. बहुत बुरी हालत हो गई थी. स्किन की भी, बॉडी की भी और हेयर्स तो बहुत ज्यादा डैमेज हो चुके थे. अक्सर डेली रूटीन में आते थे तो.
Several Indian provinces, some of which had lobbied the federal government for a relaxation in the lockdown, had said they would allow crucial businesses to restart.
An encounter broke out after security forces launched a search operation in Doda district of India's Jammu and Kashmir on Sunday. A militant belonging to Pakistan-based Hizbul Mujahideen terror outfit was killed in the encounter.
Indian security forces on Sunday gunned down Tahir Ahmad Bhatt, a militant belonging to Pakistan-based Hizbul Mujahideen terror outfit, in an encounter in the Doda district of India's Jammu and Kashmir territory. The gun battle broke out after security forces launched a search operation based on specific inputs about militants hiding in Chenab Valley's Doda district. Senior police official Mukesh Singh said one AK-47 rifle and two magazines were recovered in the operation. This comes after the four militants, including Hizbul Mujahideen commander Riaz Naiku, were killed in an encounter on May 6th. In recent weeks, the security forces have launched several searches in the region as militants from across the border have been trying to create unrest despite the coronavirus pandemic.
Moving on to news from Afghanistan, a car bomb attack targeting an Afghan intelligence agency installation in Afghanistan's Ghazni city killed at least 7 people and wounded 40 others on Monday, an official said. Taliban rebel group claimed responsibility for the attack.
A car bomb blew up near a military base in the Afghan city of Ghazni early Monday morning, killing at least 7 people in an attack claimed by Taliban insurgents. According to a statement by provincial governor of Ghazni, 40 other people were wounded in the attack. However, the numbers are likely to increase. Wahidullah Jumazada, spokesman of the provincial governor of Ghazni, in a statement confirmed that 7 people were killed and 40 others wounded in a suicide bombing attack carried out by an explosive-laden Humvee.
فایر شروع شد تقریبا 10 دقیقه بود که فایر داخل ثقافت فایر بود ما فکر کردیم اکثر وقتی چه فایر میکنن یگان فایر میکنم افکر کردیم که شاید از اون فایر ها باشه بعد از در رقبان یک انفجار بسیار قوی صورت گرفت یکی یک انفجار بود که یک رفیق میج استراحت بود من خودم میج استراحت بودم همین دروازه پلای دروازه و شیشا کرد در سرم ریخته
Taliban spokesman Zabiullah Mujahid in a statement said the rebel group was responsible for the attack. This comes as President Ashraf Ghani has condemned the recent attacks and said he had ordered the military to switch to offensive mode rather than the defensive stance it had adopted as the United States withdraws troops and tries to broker talks with the Taliban.
Moving on. The United States has welcomed the power-sharing deal between Afghan President Ashraf Ghani and his political rival Abdullah Abdullah that is expected to bring an end to months-long political crisis in war-torn Afghanistan.
After months of political deadlock, Afghanistan's President Ashraf Ghani and his political rival Abdullah Abdullah on Sunday signed a power-sharing agreement in which Ghani remains in his post and Abdullah takes a leading role in the peace process. U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo congratulated the two leaders for reaching an agreement on inclusive governance for Afghanistan and regretted the time lost during a bitter months-long feud that plunged the country into political crisis. Secretary Pompeo also urged Ghani and Abdullah for a political settlement to end surging militant violence in Afghanistan. United States Special Envoy Zalmay Khalilzad also welcomed the move and in a tweet on Sunday said the U.S. is prepared to partner with the new government in a peace process that ends the war in Afghanistan. He asserted it is high time to take seriously the resolve of the Afghan people and to finally see an end to the conflict in Afghanistan. Experts hope Sunday's agreement will help put Afghanistan on the road to greater stability. The political tension between Ghani and Abdullah emerged in February when Ghani was declared winner by the Independent Election Commission after earning a slightly higher percentage than Abdullah in last year's disputed presidential election.
Pakistan's COVID-19 tally crossed the 41,000 mark as the country has started easing lockdown restrictions to stem the spread of the virus.
The number of coronavirus cases in Pakistan jumped to more than 41,360 on Monday, with over 895 deaths reported so far as the country started to ease some of the restrictions imposed to curb the spread of the virus. Despite a rising rate of infection, Pakistan began lifting the lockdowns last week, primarily to avert an economic meltdown. Prime Minister Imran Khan had said the easing of restrictions aimed at helping the country's most impoverished citizens and warned people that the epidemic could get out of control if they did not take precautions. Meanwhile, Pakistan on Saturday resumed some domestic flights. Pakistan Civil Aviation Authority said operations would resume from five major airports in Karachi, Lahore, Islamabad, Quetta and Peshawar. Passengers and crew are being sprayed with disinfectant upon arrival and social distancing measures are being enforced in the airport and on the plane.
Nepal's COVID-19 tally reached 304 after 9 new cases of the deadly virus were confirmed on Monday. This comes as Nepal government has extended the ongoing nationwide lockdown until June 2nd.
Nepal's COVID-19 tally reached 304 after 9 new cases were reported in its Rotahat and Bara districts on Monday. Samples of the 7 men and a woman from Rotahat and of another man from Bara tested positive at the National Public Health Laboratory in capital Kathmandu, said the health ministry in a statement. According to the ministry, 36 COVID-19 patients have been discharged after recovery. However, 3 patients have been readmitted in the isolation facilities after they tested positive in retests. The Himalayan nation has so far reported 2 COVID-19 associated deaths. With the authorities increasing testing, more cases are being reported daily from across Nepal. As a stepped-up effort to deal with the outbreak, the government on Sunday extended the nationwide lockdown in place since March 24th till 2nd of June.
In news from Sri Lanka, Sri Lankan tea prices have soared driven by supply disruptions amid lockdown and spike in demand for the beverage known for its immunity-boosting properties.
The coronavirus outbreak has triggered a record spike in prices of Sri Lankan tea, with disruption in labor deployment stifling global supplies, just as millions in lockdown drive up demand for the beverage known for its immunity-boosting properties. The export price for a kilogram of tea has increased from an average of $1.86 to $3.99 at the Colombo tea auctions. A particular low-grown tea was sold at an all-time record price of $13.84 per kilogram.
Me April maase di ek hugak durata wediwime vardhanayak api dakka eka me te vendesiye nilu inna praveenyanwat man hitanne apeeksha karapu vidiyata wada wediwimak daknara labuna.
Exports for the month of March were at 13.8 million kilograms, the lowest on record, due to coronavirus affecting production and the supply line in March. The production and supply bottlenecks were resolved in April. The stifled supplies come just as global demand for food and beverages has risen, with the pandemic confining people indoors. Also, the world's most consumed drink after water is emerging as the preferred choice for many, given its low caffeine content and other health benefits.
The coronavirus lockdown has left many migrant workers stranded across India. Many of them are living in shelter homes, waiting to go back to their native places. Amid emotional roller coaster, Sheetal Agarwal, a medical clown, has been visiting shelter homes in capital New Delhi to cheer them up.
Dressing up as a clown and performing to a crowd, it's the best way Sheetal Agarwal can think of to lift the spirits of migrant workers staying in shelters in Indian capital New Delhi during a nationwide lockdown to slow the spread of coronavirus. The 34-year-old counselor was first inspired to bring cheer to children in hospitals after meeting a medical clown at a workshop about 4 years ago. She plunged wholeheartedly into the vocation, first training herself and then founded Clown Cellars back in 2016. As the lockdown stopped those routine hospital visits, which is when she began to think about helping migrant workers stranded from their homes.
So we are going to cheer them up because we feel that if staying at home we can be so unhappy or so sad and stressed, then their level of stress would be very high, considering they're not even with their families or they really are worried about the families back home. So we thought it'll be wonderful if we can bring a smile on their faces and distract them from the pain that they are feeling.
Sushila Kumari from the northern Uttar Pradesh province used to make a living by ironing clothes in New Delhi, but is now stranded at the shelter with the whole family.
ऐसे टाइम पे ऐसे माहौल में खुशी मिल रही है थोड़ा सा मतलब थोड़ा के थोड़ी देर के लिए माइंड मतलब चेंज हो जा रहा है तब कोई ख्याल नहीं आ रहा है वैसे तो ख्याल खाली घर 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 जाना है घर जाना है रोने को आ रहा है
India's strict lockdown measures have taken a toll on the million migrant workers, forcing many to work their way to home. India extended the nationwide lockdown to May 31 as cases exceeded 96,000 mark and at least 3,029 deaths were reported.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.